Welcome to A Drink of Wisdom with Jay Wise and Nathan Drinkard. I'm your host, Cody Ward. Thanks for spending some of your time with us tonight. What's going on, guys?
Let's talk some sports, baby.
This is A Drink of Wisdom.
Alright guys, I'm going to finish off with some rapid reaction. A lot of topics, a little bit of time. Let's go, Drink.
Yeah. The language of the NFL proposed collective bargaining agreement was finalized Wednesday night, and it's up to the players to vote on it. Your reaction?
I just feel like we've been talking about this for weeks now. Like, just vote and let's move on. Let's get on the free agency and the draft and all that good stuff. I'm done with this. Top-ranks owner Bob Arum is looking to sell an undisclosed portion of his promotion to expand the brand of his promotion and bring in new talent. Your thoughts?
I think it's smart by Bob Arum. He's 88. It's about time he's going to be moseying on his way out of the door here soon. So you want to bring in some new talent, also bring in another partner that can possibly move the promotion forward in his after. So, yeah, I think it's a good move. I like it. I like it a lot. The Los Angeles Chargers have agreed to a four-year, $24.5 million deal with restricted free agent running back Austin Ekeler. Good deal?
Yeah, it seems like a good deal. I mean, $6 million, that's pretty reasonable. Guy who's definitely an excellent receiver out the backfield. So he's a good player. Just don't tell me he's better than Melvin Gordon. Ooh. The Los Angeles Lakers have signed free agent guard Dion Waiters. Is he the missing piece that can put the Lakers over the top?
If he even show up to games, like – people trying to sell me this crap. Waiters Island. Why did they just sign him for the rest of the season if he's so doggone good and he got his own island? So he had to show me a little something first, and then we'll go from there. But, you know, I'm not really sold yet. I'm just not sold. Not to be outdone, the Los Angeles Clippers have signed veteran big man Joakim Noah. You see him making a big difference?
Not really. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, it just looks like the Clippers are, you know, just preparing for trying to get another body in there to go at Anthony Davis. That seems to be what this is about, because right now they only have Zubac, really, that can match up with him size-wise. So not a huge difference for me. Saturday night on Fox, it's a PBC heavyweight boxing main event at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, between Adam Kalnowski and Robert Helenius. Drink, what does this fight mean for the division?
Well, you know, the heavyweight division, we've been talking about it a lot lately, but we've just been talking about the top end, probably the top three fighters in the division. I think these two guys, I would say this about Kanoski. Right now, he's a big seller, especially in the Barclays Center. He's Polish. The Polish fans come out. They support him in droves. So he could definitely sell tickets in New York, but do he really have the talent? I'm not quite sure yet. I've seen him fight a couple of times before. Not really sold on the talent, but he's definitely a ticket seller. So we'll see, you know, that money, it matters a lot. In regards to the upcoming season, Philadelphia Phillies star right fielder Bryce Harper said, "We need to take the next step, and we actually have to do it. We can't just talk about it." Do you agree?
I agree with what he's saying right here. Obviously, the Phillies, there was a lot of hype with them entering last season with the acquisition of Bryce Harper and a lot of other guys they brought in, and they came up short, 81-81. But, hey, I will also like to hear, hey, I need to lead this. I need to hear that from Bryce Harper. You the man with the $330 million contract. Go out there and lead that team. So we'll see how it turns out. The Redskins have given 7-time Pro Bowl left tackle Trent Williams permission to seek a trade. About time, ain't it, Drink?
I feel like, just like you said in the first one, I just feel like this has like been a thing for a really, really long time. I didn't see Trent Richardson do everything but play football since he said he wanted to trade. Like, he hasn't played. They wouldn't trade him. He kind of just flopped around. I've seen a couple of boxing videos of him hitting the speed bag. I believe it when I see him actually wear a jersey and get on the field again, because I don't know what's going on with this guy. But it's a crazy situation. More left tackle news as the Philadelphia Eagles, Jason Peters, will enter free agency. Are the Eagles making a mistake by letting him walk?
I don't think so. He's 38. He's definitely on the on his last legs, it appears, even though he's started 29 of his past 32 games. But you just get the feel, like, when you talk about free agency and letting guys go, I'd always rather let a guy walk a year early than a year late. That's what's made the Patriots so great for so long. So, yeah, I think this is a good move by the Eagles. The nightcap Saturday night on pay-per-view, UFC 248 goes down in Las Vegas at the T-Mobile Arena. It's a UFC middleweight main event between the champ, Israel Adesanya, and the third-ranked Yoel Romero. Who you got, Drink?
I'm going to take the young gun, the champ, Israel Adesanya, the blade bender. He danced on the way to the octagon. He danced in the octagon, and then he danced on his way out. That's my guy. He's very entertaining. So I'm gonna take the champ on this one.
All right. That concludes today's Drink of Wisdom. I'm Cody Ward.
I'm Jay Waz.
And I'm Nathan Drinker. And remember, make tomorrow better than today and make today better than yesterday. And you know what we're going to do? We're going to holler at you until next time. Baby!